Fun Facts presents the 1956 Austin Healy 106. It is a 50s classic car. It was introduced in 1956 and had a production run through 1959. I'm partial to this body style. I used to have a Mach 3 Austin Healy. I loved it. It was amazing. I'm excited. I hope you're excited. And let's get started now. The Austin Healy 106 is a two-seat roadster that was announced in late September 1956 and produced from 1956 until 1959, a replacement for the Austin Healy 100. It was followed by the Austin Healy 3000. Together, the three models have become known as the Big Healys. The 106 featured a 2-inch 50.8 millimeter longer wheelbase than the 100, a more powerful straight six engine in place of the slightly larger inline four, and added two occasional seats, which later became optional. The body lines were slightly streamlined, a smaller, wider radiator grille placed lower, and air scoop was added to the bonnet, and the windscreen fixed. The 106 was produced in two model designators, the 2 plus 2 BN4 from 1956 onwards and the two-seat BN6 in 1958. The cars used a tuned version of the BMC C-Series engine previously fitted to the Austin Westminster, initially producing 102 bhp. And increased in 1957 to 117 bhp by refitting and revising the manifold and the cylinder heads. The previously standard overdrive unit was made optional. In late 57, production was transferred from the Long Bridge to the MG plant at Abingdon. 14,436 106s were produced before production ended in 1959. A 117 bhp BN6 was tested by the Motor Magazine, and in 1959 it had a top speed of 103.9 miles per hour and could accelerate from 0 to 60 in 10.7 seconds, and the fuel consumption of the 20.8 miles imperial gallon was recorded. The test car cost 1,307 euros, including taxes. The British Motor Company Corporation built the Austin Healy 100 sports car between 1953 and 1956, developed by Don Healy. It was produced in-house by Healy Small Car Company in Warwick and based on Austin's A90 Atlantic Mechanicals. A single Healy 100 was built for the 1952 London Motor Show and designed impressed showgoers, including Leonard Lord, managing director of Austin, who struck a deal with Healy to build it in quantity at Austin's Long Bridge factory. The car was renamed the Austin Healy 100, and the first 100s, series BN1, were equipped with the same 90 horsepower engine and manual transmission found in the A90, but the transmission was modified to be a three-speed unit with overdrive and a top two gears. 11-inch Girling drum brakes provided the stopping power, and the front suspension was independent using coil springs. And in the back was rigid axle with a semi-elliptic leaf spring, and the steering was by a cam and lever system. After Austin Healy's 100 debut at the 1952 Motor Show, the works had entered two mildly modified cars in 1953 Le Mans 24-hour race. with one placing 12th and the other 14th. According to the name, Le Mans was chosen for the bolt-on tuning kit offered through Austin Healy dealers. This allowed private owners to modify their 100s up to the specification approaching that of the works entries. The kit included high lift camshaft, stronger valve springs, a distributor with an alternative ignition advance curve, and a pair of 1¾-inch SUHD 6 carburetors, plus a special inlet manifold and cold air box. The conversion was available from October 55 from the factory on the successor BN2 model in the form of the 100M. Along with the Le Mans kit, it added high compression pistons, special Armstrong front dampers, a louvre bonnet, and a stiffer front anti-roll bar. Power rose to 100 bhp, and the windscreen folded flat was capable of achieving 120 miles per hour top speed. 1,159 examples, mostly BN2s, were built or subsequently modified to 100M specifications between 1955 and 1956. Of these, approximately 640 were completed at the factory, some 544 of which were exported to the USA. The Austin Healy 100s, S for the Sebring, developed 132 horsepower at 4,700 RPM. The factory had produced five development test cars during 53 and 1954, and the SPL chassis number prefix. One example won its class at Sebring in 1954, thus the S designation. 50 production examples of the 100S were hand-built by Don Healy Motor Company at Warwick, with deliveries between February and November of 1955 and the AHS chassis number prefix. Among the modifications made the 100S including replacing the cast iron cylinder head with a Westlake designed aluminum one, Dunlop disc brakes fitted at all four corners, and the overdrive unit was not installed. Thus, 100S became the world's first production car to employ disc brakes in the front and rear. Along with improved performance, the weight of the 100S was reduced by the removal of the bumpers. The windscreen was made of plastic and the grille was reduced in size. Approximately 200 pounds were shed in the process, complementing the increased performance of the engine. Most of the Healy 100S's were two-toned white with labellia blue side paint schemes. A few examples wore solid spruce green and red paintwork. A single example was finished in black. The Austin Healy succeeded at being a low-cost, high-performance, limited-production sports car aimed at the United States market. They provided 100 mile per hour performance, dramatic styling, and thrilling open motoring at a fair price. The Austin Healy 100 was introduced in October of 1952 at the Earl's Court Motor Show, and the first Austin Healy 100s were known as the 104 and the BN1. The name 100 came about by being able to break the 100 mile per hour barrier. The BN also had meaning. The B represented the engine class, which meant it had to be between 2,000 and 3,000 cc's, and the N represented the body style configuration, a two-seat and open top. Okay. Well, if you found yourself this far into the video, we'd certainly like to thank you for taking time out of your day to watch our video. And if you like our video, please give us a thumbs up because it really does help our channel. And if you like our channel, please subscribe because we'll be doing all of the sports cars from the 50s and concept cars. We'll be doing all of the 60s sports cars and concept cars and muscle cars. Later we'll be getting into the 50s and 60s trucks that were being built primarily in the USA. We'll be covering auto shows, autoramas, custom car shows, custom cars, hot rods, We'll be doing supercars, hybrid cars. We'll be featuring just about every automobile from the 50s, 60s, and 70s. So we hope to see you when we upload our next video. And always, always, always take good care. Thank you.